Hello, everyone. A couple of years ago, I was working as an internship student in London, and we were basically trying to create something similar to Heroku or App Engine, but do it for generic applications, so host any kind of application. And after quite a while, it became clear that the messaging infrastructure became extremely complicated and extremely brittle. And I was very, very frustrated because the effort required to scale, so to say, the hardware is a one-liner, a single line of code. While if you look at the challenges required to scale the software, well, I don't have to detail them. There are a lot of challenges. But honestly, is convincing hundreds of thousands of physical machines to do something easier than convincing a few handful of virtual machines? So what's the difference? Well, actually, there are what virtual machines did with physical machines is that they imposed certain limitations. And by imposing the limitations, they managed to simplify things. What I'm proposing is that we should do the same thing. Just impose a few limitations to what the communication system can do. Of course, that will mean that 90% of the application, so we'll reduce our usage by 10%. But for the rest of the 90% of the applications, we can create something much, much simpler. And what are the main challenges with distributed systems? Well, or main complexity? Well, first of all, that most messaging systems deal with instances. But honestly, if you have three databases, database A, B, C, do you really care which one will reply to your requests? Not really. You can put a load balancer in front of it, but that's just adding extra components. The other complexities comes from addressing. Everybody uses numerical IP addresses, or, well, let's just say numerical IP addresses. But the problem is that with cloud computing, IP addresses come and go. The virtual machines change underneath the IP address. So if you stick to IPs, you're going to have a bad time. And the last one is security. Well, since security is complicated, most people just leave it for later, and usually they don't get, so security doesn't get implemented. So how can we make this simpler? Well, first of all, we should consolidate instances into clusters. What we should do is basically make clusters as the smallest logical unit that our client, our service, use. What are the benefits of this? Well, mainly, is that it's much harder to abuse. So if I cannot message instances separately, then it's much harder for me to introduce single points of failure. Additionally, there are lots of significantly less moving components in my system, and I can also convince my system to self-organize itself. Secondly, if I have these little clusters as the smallest units, what I can do actually is assign names to each of those clusters. So if I just have a cluster of web servers, I don't have web server ABC anymore, then I don't really want to communicate with web server ABC anymore, just the cluster. So I can replace numerical addresses with semantic addresses. And this is actually a very, very powerful thing because I can have implicit failovers. If I have three databases and one of them fails, well, the system doesn't care, the system doesn't even see, just sees databases. Is somebody there to reply? Cool. And the other thing is that can be done is load balancing, the same mechanism, basically. You can add nodes, remove nodes, the system doesn't care about it. And lastly, many messaging systems took the route that, okay, security, will add security later. For example, Erlang hasn't added security yet in its 20 years of existence because it got that complicated. ZeroMQ are working and trying really hard to add it now, but it's a lot of effort. So you really should add it from day one. Actually, from day zero, sorry. And the other thing is that a lot of people, I think, overcomplicate, is that when people add security, what they do is instead of creating a lax security model, they try to create it really, really tight. So every instance has a completely separate security entity, and then it just becomes really hard to maintain. So if you can, if you have a service running inside the cloud, but trust the service as a whole. You don't have to create a separate security entity for each of them. And it will allow you a lot of optimizations. And it will also allow you your system to be decoupled. And if you take these three core concepts, if you can create a messaging system that implements these three core concepts, you basically create something that is very, very easy to scale. You just can add nodes, remove nodes whenever you want, and it scales by itself. And this is basically these are the concepts behind Iris, which is, well, basically my PhD. And what I really try to do, and actually achieve to do, is to if I can rent 100 virtual machines with one line, then I can make them communicate with another line. Of course, I won't have time to go into details. It has peer-to-peer networks in its service discovery. But the really cool thing is that on every virtual machine, I can simply start up an Iris node. It acts as a local agent. And really thin, dumb clients can communicate, can connect to that node and just say, OK, I'm a web server. Immediately, we will get requests for web servers. And I can just send requests to the whole network without caring who is in the network and where he is in the network. Thank you.